Good afternoon. Welcome to the parish community of Mary, Mother of God. We'd especially like to welcome our new parishioners and all those visiting with us this weekend. Today we celebrate the feast of our Lord Jesus Christ, King of the Universe. We begin our celebration in song. Please join in singing, Crown Him with Many Crowns. Please rise and join in singing.
Christ the King, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. May our Lord be with you. So this is the end of the church year. Next week, our calendar begins a new year with the first Sunday of Advent. You'll have the new books will be put in later in the day tomorrow. So you'll have new books next week. Back to having books. I'm sure you'll be very happy. Thank Jillian so much for presenting a little worship aid for us every single week for much of the year. So next week, a new year, a new day. You know, it's the crown, only crown Jesus ever wore. It was a crown of thorns sitting here right in front of me. Very interesting feast, Christ the King. Let us look back and call to mind our sins. Lord Jesus, you came to gather all the nations into the peace of your Father's kingdom. Lord, have mercy. You come now in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy. You'll come again in glory with salvation for your people at the end of time. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
We bless you.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, whose will is to restore all things in your beloved Son, the King of the universe, grant, we pray, that all creation, set free from slavery to sin, may render your majesty service and ceaselessly proclaim your praise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Daniel. As the visions during the night continued, I saw one like a son of man coming on the clouds of heaven. When he reached the ancient one and was presented before him, the one like a son of man received dominion, glory, and kingship. All peoples, nations, and languages serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion that shall not be taken away. His kingship shall not be destroyed. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord. A reading from the book of Revelation. Jesus Christ is the faithful witness, the firstborn of the dead and ruler of the kings of the earth. To him who loves us and has freed us from our sins by his blood, who has made us into a kingdom, priests for his God and Father, to him be glory and power forever and ever. Amen. Behold, he is coming amid the clouds, and every eye will see him, even those who pierced him. All the people of the earth will lament him. Yes, amen. I am the Alpha and the Omega, says the Lord God, the one who is and who was and who is to come, the Almighty. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. May the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Pilate said to Jesus, "Are you the King of the Jews?" Jesus answered, "Do you say this on your own, or have others told you about me?" Pilate answered, "I'm not a Jew, am I? Your own nation, chief priests, have handed you over to me. What have you done?" Jesus answered, "My kingdom does not belong to this world. If my kingdom did belong to this world, my attendants would be fighting to keep me from being handed over to the Jews. But as it is, my kingdom is not here." So Pilate said, "Then you are a king." Jesus answered, "You say I'm a king. For this I was born, and for this I came into the world, to testify to the truth. Everyone who belongs to the truth listens to my voice." The Gospel of the Lord. So it's an interesting feast that brings the church year to an end. Beginning next week, we'll hear from Luke all year. So if you had a chance to see Hamilton, I have not, because of the COVID and stuff, and it's a very expensive show to see. But there's a line in it, and I'm paraphrasing, that says, "You wanted a revolution. What you got was a revelation." And that might fit, really, the whole story. When Jesus is born, and you guys are very good Catholics, you know the story, his first visitors are the wise men, and they come and they say, "Where's the newborn king of the Jews?" And you kind of spend the rest of the time, does Jesus see himself as a king? Well, the Jews wanted and needed a revolution. Somebody to throw the Romans out of the Holy Land, out of Palestine, get Jerusalem back to where we're in charge instead of the Romans dominating us. A military, a political revolution. And with good reason they wanted that, because they hated the Romans. But you didn't get a revolution. You got a revelation. The Romans did not get, Jesus did not throw anybody out. He had no weapons, he had no armies. And he hated the idea of being some kind of a political or military leader, a king in that sense. The only crown he ever wore was a crown of thorns. The only throne he ever sat on was the cross.
He was not what they wanted. Herod killed every newborn boy. As you know, Herod or Pilate will kill Jesus. He was not what they wanted. He was not what they wanted. Could we, the average person in the pew, sometimes be guilty of trying to make Jesus and God into what we want them to be instead of what they really are? We could be guilty of the same missing Jesus. Like, what's the number one thing a priest gets asked? Father, will you pray for my daughter so she gets the job? Okay, like Jesus is a, you know, is a Mr. Fix-It who's going to make everything go the way you want it to go. And that's okay. I'll say that prayer for you gladly. But Jesus is not a Mr. Fix-It who's going to get you everything you want. It doesn't work that way. Jesus is not some magician. Or we make God into a lifeguard. Would you say a prayer that my biopsy comes out good instead of malignant? God's not a lifeguard. It'd be better to say, Father, help me to accept whatever the results show, that God will give me the grace to deal with bad news if I get it. That would be being more fair to God instead of making God into what I need him to be right now. Now, we all do that. Pray, pass this test. Or now, only the kids would not know what this is. Remember the number two pencils always had an eraser on top? I don't think the kids know what an eraser is. But we want God to be an eraser. Like, we want to go to confession, and God will erase the sin. Well, God will erase the sin. He will. But the job isn't to get your kid to go to confession. The job is to get your kid to undergo conversion. It's easy to go to confession, but to say, I firmly resolve with the help of thy grace to sin no more. In other words, I'm going to stop going to the places where I find the temptation, which may be a website, it may be a bar, whatever. God will forgive you, but you have to say, how am I going to change? Or else you'll be back to confession in a month. God's not an eraser alone. But if we shape God into what we want him or need him to be, then we're no better than the Jews were, who missed him. They missed him. They missed him. They're still waiting. They're still waiting. The funny thing about the story, maybe nobody ever explained this to you before, Pilate probably spoke Greek, as the Romans did. Jesus spoke Aramaic, which is like Hebrew. They must have had somebody translating with each other because they did not speak the same language. They didn't. We're quite sure of that. And when you need a translator, sometimes things get lost in the translation. That's the risk you take, English to Spanish. Sometimes it's said differently. We have people in the parish who speak mostly Italian because there's no word in English for that word that they use in Italian. Things get lost in the translation. Do we sometimes lose Jesus in the translation of what we want and need him to be instead of what he is? That's not the Jesus they wanted. A king with power. Or do we want Jesus, a king of love and compassion? That decision is ours, yours and mine to make. Let us stand, my friends, and we'll profess our faith in Almighty God. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father.
Through him all things are made. For us men and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We put our prayers before Almighty God.
The response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. For our Holy Father and all teachers of the faith, may they speak truth to power as disciples of the one who is the way, the truth, and the life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For judges and those who are sworn to uphold the truth, may they dispense justice equally and without partiality. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the victims of tyranny, persecution, oppression, or racism, that the justice of Christ the King will rid the world of every trace of hatred. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our military, police, firefighters, first responders, and healthcare workers, and all those serving in dangerous professions, that the Holy Spirit will guide, direct, and protect them at all times. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the containment and eradication of the COVID-19 virus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Edward and Elizabeth Thomasitis, for whom this Mass is being offered, that they may live eternally with Christ their Lord. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us end the petitions by praying the vision prayer.
Jesus, we are your people. We praise you as Savior and Lord. Deepen our commitment to you, your church, and each other. Let us all share more actively in spreading the good news of God present among us. Help us reach out to those who have not yet experienced the joy of participating in parish life. Inspire us to seek justice and peace for all members of our parish family and beyond. Assist us in living your gospel of compassion and love in service to those in need. Mindful of our many blessings, we are especially grateful for your gift of our parish family, a family dedicated to Mary, Mother of God, her spouse, Joseph, and our beloved saints, Anthony, Vincent, Stanislaus, and Stephen. Lord, send us your spirit. Make us alive as we have never been. Let us celebrate together and place our hope in you. Amen. Pray, friends, that my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. As we offer you, Lord, the sacrifice by which the human race is reconciled to you, we humbly pray that your Son himself may bestow on all people gifts of unity and peace. We ask this through Christ, our Lord. Amen. May the Lord be with you.
Spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. You anointed your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, the oil of gladness, the eternal priest, King of all creation, so that by offering himself on the altar of the cross as a spotless sacrifice to bring us peace, he might accomplish the mystery of human redemption, making all created things subject to his rule. And he might present to the immensity of your majesty an eternal and universal kingdom, kingdom of truth, life, holiness, grace, justice, love, and peace. And so with angels, archangels, thrones, minions, and all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing an unending hymn of your praise. Therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper ended, he took a chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, blood of a new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Mystery of faith.
Celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks they've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity with Francis, our Pope, Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, all who died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and praise you and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from ever evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Peace to the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
We share some sign of Christ's peace. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
During communion, please join in singing, Behold the Lamb.
So we're happy to introduce, and you're the first to see these, our annual homemade, with the help of our sister parish in North Carolina, Advent reflection books, which take a tremendous amount of work to put this together. And I don't want to mention all the names of the people who make it work. You will know some of the names. You won't know some of them because they don't live here. They are down in North Carolina, and they have a good parish, too much smaller, very, very, very small parish, but so they contribute too. So it's a daily little reflection. Please take one, maybe one per family, and if you have friends you know are shut-ins who don't get to Mass, take one for them. They tend to disappear quickly, and there are only so many made, a couple hundred, I believe. So, and at the front, it's such a great name, for great in your midst is the Holy One of Israel. That's just a great line, which we'll hear in the Christmas season. So take one. Now, next week, pay attention as Advent comes. You know, we put the Christmas ornaments on the tree, and you are incredibly generous. That auditorium is filled with presents, some of which are very expensive. Let me say that. Your generosity never ceases to amaze me. What happens when Thanksgiving and the first Sunday of Advent fall on the same weekend, some people aren't here. Maybe they go away, and they come back the next week, and there are no ornaments left. We only have so many names given to us for whom to buy presents. And you come back and the thing is bare. Well, what can you do? Well, we can do something. If they're all gone, or if you don't want to spend as much as maybe some of those gifts sometimes entail, you can do a couple other things. You can buy men's boxer shorts. I hate to be so practical about it, but that's what homeless men like. Philadelphia is no different. And that's for the Keystone Mission over on Olive Street, right by Scranton High School. That's what they're looking for. So that may be, if you can't get an ornament, or if you might not want to get into that much money, a pair, you know, just a nice set of three or whatever would be a nice gift, and there'll be a box in the back. Or for our own homebound, you can bring, it's in the bulletin, like tissues or soaps, things like that, that a 90-year-old might really appreciate. And they do appreciate getting something from their church. As they get communion, they also get a little present. So there's a couple different options. Something there should work if you want to spread the grace and love God has given you to those who maybe don't get to church or are homeless or kids who don't have a family, whatever. So we give you lots of options, and you do with that what you want. So it's obviously a very busy time of the year coming up. Let us all stand to pray. Having received the food of immortality, we ask, Lord, that in glorifying and obedience to the commands of Christ, the King of the whole universe, we may live with him eternally in his heavenly kingdom, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. May the Lord be with you. Almighty God bless us and all of our families, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Our liturgy ends. We go in peace, glorifying God with our lives. Thanks be to God.